So let's take a look at what's called the accessibility shortcut on your iPhone. But you may know it as the triple click or triple press. It's what happens when you quickly three times press the home button on your iPhone, or in an iPhone X you quickly press the side button three times. Now different people may think different things happen when you do this. That's because you can control what happens. You have the ability to set that in settings. So let's take a look. Go into settings and under general and then accessibility, we're going to go all the way to the bottom and you see accessibility shortcut. I'm going to tap that and you can see a list of things and a check mark next to one of them. So in this case, since there's one check mark, that's what's going to happen when I triple press the home button. In this case, it'll go to the magnifier, which a lot of people may expect. It just uses the camera to show you things on the screen, kind of like having the camera on, but you can zoom in very easily. It's useful for reading like the ingredients on food products and things like that. But you can add different things to it. So for instance, let's add classic invert colors, smart invert colors, and reduce white point. Now when I have all three of these added, let's take a look and see what happens. I'll go into photos here and I'm going to triple click the home button and you can see I get a menu now. So instead of going right to the magnifier, it gives me magnifier as an option, but also the other ones that I chose. So for instance, I could do classic invert, which you can see inverts the entire screen so all the pictures look funny. Or I can go to smart invert, which is smart enough to invert parts of the screen like the background there, but leave things like photos and icons and such the same. This is kind of like a dark mode for your iPhone. You can also go like reduce white point is actually going to add on there to the smart invert. I'll turn that off. And it's kind of give me a dimmed view. And you can adjust that in accessibility. I can turn that all off. So you can see I have access to many different things there when I turn on many different things. Now magnifier is grayed out, meaning I can't turn it off, but I can. The key is that I would need to go and find the magnifier function and actually turn that off itself. So if I turn off magnifier, then that item is now no longer there. Some of the other functions work like that as well. For instance, guided access isn't even in the list, but if I turn it on, now it is in the list and grayed out. So there are things like that. So what do the rest of these do? Well, color filters allows you to access a whole bunch of different ways to tint the screen and do things with it. It doesn't show up on screen capture, so I won't be able to show you that. Assistive touch and switch control allow you to do all sorts of different things to make it easier to touch the screen if for people that have difficulty using a touch screen. And zoom allows you to zoom in various ways depending upon how you have things checked. Now many of these things will work depending upon how your accessibility settings are set. So for instance, zoom here, there's a bunch of different ways zoom could be set up. The same thing for all those touch accessibility options. The colors themselves under display accommodations, there's color filters and you can check out all the different ways you can do that. So basically, a lot of those have additional options, but you need to go and find them in the long list of accessibility options to be able to control what it does. But the important thing is that if you always wondered how you set what happens when you triple click or how you can access multiple options when you triple click, this is where you go to it. You even have the ability on the right here to drag the order so you can change what order these are in so they appear in the menu, maybe the one you use the most closest to the home button at the bottom of the screen. So check those out. Maybe enable a bunch of them and try using them for a little while to see which ones are useful and then just stick with the ones that you want to keep.